Okay, hi everyone. We're back. We're back from the maiden voyage. We've been back for a little while, but it's taken me a moment to get this little video together. Sorry about that. The maiden voyage was a success. It was a really good test run. So much so, it deserves a happy dance.
Bring me down, I said. Tell you now. Bring me down.
So as you can see, we were pretty chuffed with ourselves about actually doing the maiden voyage, but it didn't go, you know, completely smoothly. Why? How could it? It's a maiden voyage. It wasn't meant to. It was never meant to. So the biggest issues I had was towing, of course. That we always knew that was going to be the main issues. But the first couple of hours, I was cruising along. I was sitting on probably 100, and I thought, what is everyone talking about? I've got to sit on 80 or 90. This thing's a beast. We're like doing it in style and quickly. But that was on the dead flat ground. Now, after a couple of hours, we started to hit hills, just little hills, and I immediately noticed how much the car just slowed down. As soon as you hit a slight incline, the car just slowed down. Not completely, but you know, enough to have everyone whiz past you. So I was like, oh dear, okay, well at least I'm not going up the Dorrigo Mountain, at least I'm going to go around the back way. But the thing with the East Australian coastline, there's a mountain range that runs the whole way along. So even though I didn't go the steep route, which was up near Coffs, the Dorrigo Mountain, I decided to go down and around. I, of course, still had to get over the mountain range at some point. So with the car slowing down as it was, I knew I was in a little bit of trouble when I started to hit signs, when they've got the steep incline sign at the bottom saying, you know, watch out, this is going to be big. I knew I was in a bit of trouble then. So much trouble that I had to go all the way back to second gear. And I thought it was going to stop. I thought I was going to cry. I thought I was going to be the girl and her kid and her two dogs that have somehow stalled on the mountainside and then jackknifed the caravan and were completely blocking all lanes of traffic. I thought that was going to be me with the helicopters going around the top, you know. Then they'd say it's the McLeod's daughter's girl and be on the news. It'd be very embarrassing. It all flashed before my eyes. That's what was going to happen. But thank goodness I didn't stop. I was in second and I was going at a piddly, you know, 10 or 15 k's an hour with just zillions of trucks, angry, very angry trucks and drivers behind me, all wanting to get past. But they couldn't get past, could they? No, they couldn't because I was stuck in second. So they just had to wait. So when they did pass, they all beeped at me and, oh, it's just horrible. It felt ill. But we did it. The car did it. It didn't stop. It just kept going at very, very slow speed. So I'm looking into getting the car a bit more power now while I'm back in Coffs Harbour. That's the plan. So I kind of get up the mountains. I'm getting closer to where I am supposed to be going. And then we see a big, big black sky.
No one ever did speak. She's the last true.
So you know when you see a big black sky like that, it's going to be trouble. It can't be good. Not if you're driving into it, which we were. But it wasn't the end of the trouble, just the black sky. No, no. The very next thing was this.
And very mean. The weather's turned bad. That's like hail slash rain slash sleet. I guess that's what you call it.
It was dark and I was over.
See, funny, right? No, wasn't funny. I shouldn't have been laughing because what I was about to do was head to my friend's, the driveway. The driveway was about a 20-minute long mud, well, it was supposed to be dirt, but because of that sleet storm, it was now mud, driveway that also was 650 metres above sea level. So it the driveway was always going to be the biggest problem that I had. So on approach, I was feeling quite ill. I was on the verge of tears, knowing already, you know, how the car had to go back to second on the normal roads. How on earth was I going to do it in a sleet storm on mud, black mud? I didn't know. I felt ill. But my friend's dad met me at the front gate, and he made sure I was in, you know, low range, diff lock. And he just said, keep it in second and just keep pushing. And that's what I did. I would have videoed, but I was almost crying. And I wasn't allowed to cry because it was already raining. You can't cry and drive in the rain, in the mud, up a very steep mountain. That would be dangerous and it would be silly. So I couldn't cry. Although I really, really, really wanted to. But I got to the top anyway, and then I got a glimpse at a pretty cool view.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this way...
So I made it. You know, the Defender made it, the little tractor that it is, it just chugged on up there and we got up. And then you've seen a little bit of the rest of our time. The highlights, of course, were the quad bikes were fun, really fun. And then the next thing we did was a muster. Couldn't do it on the horses. The horses hadn't been ridden for a long time. So we did it in Jeeps, two Jeeps and one quad bike. And for me, this was the absolute highlight because Madigan, he was just in his element and he just had such a blast. He was such a good little cowboy. Check him out. He's so cute. So that's it, really. That was the maiden voyage. A scary success. And we did it. And we only have to do a maiden voyage once. So, and I think that was a good one. It really put me through the ringer on all counts. So I should be able to take on anything now. Okay, that's it. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you soon on the road. Bye.